motivation to get, like, going on a Sunday morning, be like, none. It's all bouncy. Oof.
We are in that cosplay prep. We got most things packed already. Sam is in all makeup and everything except wig. Just like I'm in everything except wig, but we'll get there. And the state of getting ready that we are in is pants tucking.
Pants tucking.
Which you always forget.
Where we're at.
And look at Meredith. Meredith, like, really be just looking great.
I really just, like, be trying to be Aziraphale.
He's just so ethereal.
Really cute.
You saw them in that dimly lit restaurant, but...
But now. In high def.
Room
lighting.
Look at the radiance of Meredith Aziraphale. And look at Luke's Crowley, and honestly...
Luke's Crowley kin, by the way. He's a Crowley kinny.
Low-key, yeah.
You guys look so effing good.
Nice.
I just filmed your butt. Sorry.
Yay.
Okay, Luke, you know you were talking about that water bottle you said went missing?
I found it, actually. So if we found another one, then we really just...
We actually are almost done.
For real this time.
Does someone want this?
Nope.
This mysterious water bottle we found under the bed.
So...
I be kicking stuff, you know, I haven't seen anything. Also, you guys left your soap. You want it?
I don't care.
Okay.
It was body wash and...
I'm gonna see if that is, like, a black spot, and if it is actually what I think it is, I'm just gonna leave it, and it's gonna be part of Finn. Yeah, it's just gonna be part of Finn.
What?
I found, like, some of them when I was wiping away the tattoos.
Like,
it's, like, right here.
Dance.
I'm like,
gosh, just
I'm like, just,
like
he's just a dirty,
or, like,
dirty boy.
Okay.
Right. 1 hour later.
We're back online?
Just vibe check.
Can I get your picture, please?
Look at this whole group of celestial motherfuckers. I can dim the lights and sing you songs full of sad things. We can do the tango just for two. I can serenade and gently play on your heartstrings. Be your Valentino, just me.
Thank you. really like gorgeous.
I'm sorry if I'm in anyone's way. This is a video, honey. It was on video. Okay, can you pose again?
Ain't just like babies.
We can be a family. That's it. I stole this. We can be a family now.
I stole this for you. Oh. I don't know where she is, and I'm lost and don't know where to go, so I gotta go find her. Bye.
You ever just find something really cute? I did.
Yo.
Those are really cool.
There's a zero okay. fail button in here somewhere.
I love those.
I'm sad though because I wanted to get this one pin and they were sold out of it. I was like, give me the husbands.
Give me the husbands.
But Luke
made
me because he got me.
We're just enjoying our lollipops.
We love that.
Candy, we're happy.
Tiny little photos.
I love them so much.
They're so cute.
Okay,
I'm gonna turn this.
Aww. Ooh, yeah.
Is that Winnie the Pooh?
Mm-hmm.
I'm crying.
My boy, let me see this. Hold on. Oh my god. Fantastic. I love that.
Ready? Mm-hmm. Okay. Let me just make sure there's the right person.
Okay.
Meredith?
Yes.
Happy Valentine's Day.
I'm sorry, I got a little bent.
Oh!
Aww.
Aww. And Luke.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Bitch, when we walked by, they were like, we're out of Crowley.
Yeah, they were like, they're out of Crowley.
Sam.
Thank you, everyone, for coming.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh, thank you, because I wanted it. But I didn't. It's like, do not separate them.
It's like, no.
I love these, thank you. Sorry, I like.
For the record, I like how you knew who to look at. I was like,
it was definitely me.
It's my Aziraphale eat a bag.
Oh.
Oh no.
No, I'm like happy because I like having
straight up trying it.
Sam, I like having duplicates of things.
Oh yeah.
It makes it look more authentic. I was telling Luke like I want to get like one of those little eat a purses because I won't have enough Good Omens stuff to make a whole bag. Yeah. I'd love to make just like a little Good Omens purse. Like
there you go.
So like, listen. Do not separate them.
Oh wait, I forgot. There was one other thing I bought. So besides Sam buying me this wonderful button-up of like video game, the other thing I bought was this Yu-Gi-Oh! Glass cleaner cloth. And honestly,
like my Yu-Gi-Oh! Glass cleaner.
Honestly, I needed a new one because it was falling apart at home. So I was like, okay.
When you wear glasses almost exclusively, you sit and you're like, I need it to be clean.
No, that's good to have your glasses clean.
Mm-hmm. Well, it also can clean your phone screen, so that's nice.
Yeah.
I got my husband Solus and my alien husband Jaw.
Jaw.
He always says the nicest things to me.
Wait, do it.
And then I got, Morgan got me. Kagome and Inuyasha's really aesthetically pleasing shirt. They did not have a small or a medium, so I got a large.
But we can tailor.
But I can tailor it if it's too big, or I can just like be like just hip and cool with my baggy shirt and like tight pants. So.
But yeah.
We're gonna go take a couple more pictures and
we're gonna go get some ice cream.
Because that's, yeah. You know what? That's usually our con thing. It's like, all right, last day, let's go get milkshakes and or ice cream.
Yeah.
But there's no,
well, I mean, there is a
long walk. But it's like
a long walk.
It's
walking
a
distance,
long walk, so. And we don't want to do that.
That McDonald's is like, far away, and I don't want to spend money on
using your
Uber.
Camera to fix my wig, but it's honestly,
here.
I fell asleep on it, so like, good enough.
There we go. Nice. Is it even us at the end of a con if we're not having some form of like ice cream at the end of it?
I'm a zero fail.
Aziraphale being like, got a double fisted.
What do I do with all these ice creams?
Oh no, what if I have them? Oh no.
Yum. Don't know if you guys can see it, but that is traffic. So as we sit here, we're gonna do our recap.
Traffic, vlogging time, go! Traffic.
Let's go! Woo! Alright guys.
Empty. Favorite part of the con.
Morgan, you start us off. Favorite part of the con.
No, I asked the question. I can't answer first.
Yes, you can.
You have to answer first, and you always answer first.
Oh, do I?
Yes, you do.
I think favorite part was actually when we got in our kikurumis on Friday.
Oh, mood.
And then we went and had dinner together, and then we like just like chilled and ate food, and then just like, I don't know. I just like to hang out with you guys a lot, so that was my favorite.
Sorry, I don't know how to help with that yet.
I'm not talking to you!
Go away.
Yes.
I heard it, I was like,
who's talking?
Whose phone just...
Yeah. You want to go, Sam? I can hold it.
Okay. Sam's next.
It's me. Oh god. Yep. I don't know why, because I do this every...
The most complicated way to turn it around possible.
Hello.
Good lord.
It's me. My favorite part of the con... Yeah, I think I agree. I think it was being our kikus and just eating dinner together and just hanging out. That's just about the stealing your thing, so let me think of something different that I really liked. It's not really part of the con, but Thursday night we like... We had two queen size beds in the room. All four of us got in one, and we were just snuggling and watched Demon Slayer because we were all like, "What is this?"
We were all like, "Rip,
rip." We were already tired. Another favorite part was the Met Gala, the Casa Met Gala.
Oh yeah,
it was really really fun. And then I something needs to okay, is oh, we were in the artist alley, and oh my god, we were in the artist alley, and someone was like, "Oh my gosh, I follow you two on Instagram," and I went,
"Oh my god,
what? Oh what?" And she was like, "Oh my gosh, you guys inspired me to cosplay," and I went, "What?"
And got ugly, and like I. I was at the artist booth, and I was like, "I'm sorry, I'm emotional." And I was like crying at her booth, and I'm like, "Sorry about this."
All right, Meredith, favorite part of the con?
My favorite part of the con was definitely doing French Revolution Aziraphale and Crowley. I've just never had a cosplay where I was like so happy with it, and it was just fun to walk around in it. And every time that somebody was like, "Hey, oh my gosh," or whatever, like, "It's Aziraphale and Crowley." I was just like, "Oh!" Like, so many people took pictures of us, and it was just a lot of fun.
It was a lot of
fun. It's nice to see people on Instagram.
We talked about it a little bit. I'll lean into Meredith. We talked about it a little bit yesterday, but I don't know if we did it on camera or not, but just it's like the perfect, like, Venn diagram cosplay of, like, nerdy, like Good Omens
people see people it
versus like
people see
Lolita
it
or just fashion people.
They like Good Omens and they're like, "Oh yeah, it's Good Omens, like I get it," and they love it. But then also people walk up to you that are just like either fashion enthusiasts or Lolita, like "Oh, I love your outfit."
Yeah.
And I'm like,
"Thank you.
I really appreciate it, thank you."
I just like also being tall, I like wearing really big feathers.
Good.
And also really big hip pads.
Uh-huh.
Good take. Luke, favorite part of the con?
I have a couple. I really like being dressed up as Crowley, just in general, but
he's
mostly just like
kid.
Normal
You're
Crowley,
because
I don't have to wear a wig, but like, can't relate. One of the characters that I like, feel really, really confident in or whatever, which is like,
you look so good as Crowley.
Honestly, yeah. Let me just... every time I see you as Crowley and, like, you have Aziraphale, I don't know why, I'm just like, "Oh my god!
Really,
oh my god!"
Like, the entire time, like, we were like, "Oh my god!" It was just nice to be in a con and, like, pass by a mirror and look at it and be like, "Oh, I don't look disgusting."
Mm.
I was like, this is... new. Like, I kept waiting for it to happen. Every time I looked in, like, a mirror, I was, like, I kept expecting to be, like, "Oh, gross, there it is." But, like, I did it, and I was, like, it was really nice.
It's, like, I don't know.
I just More love Good Omens. Watch Good Omens.
You watch Good Omens.
Watch Good Omens on Amazon Prime.
Support the show. Go watch it.
Yeah.
There's no way out. There's no ethical consumption under capitalism. Listen.
Morgan.
Huh?
Least favorite part of the con.
Do I have a least favorite?
Yeah.
Oh, getting a wig burn, otherwise known as, now I know, it's folliculitis, which is basically you have too much pressure on one point
there's
on your scalp.
Trap ahead.
I know there's a speed trap. I've seen the policeman right there. It's basically when your wig cap is too, or your wig, whatever, is too tight on your head, and it will constantly rub that one area, and your hair follicles get irritated, and they can form these, like, it's gonna sound gross, like, blisteries on your scalp, and they'll go away by themselves, but it can get bad enough, and you can, like, end up with, like, scabs all over your scalp, and then your hair falls out. So,
we've done some research, can you tell?
We've done some research. This has happened to me before, but, like...
It also is... Mm-hmm. It happens more if your skin is already sensitive.
Hi. I'm hypoallergenic skin over here.
But, yeah, so that's your least favorite part?
Yeah, I think that was my least favorite part.
You're right.
I can't think of any other part that I, like... Least favorite. Maybe, the waitress from that one restaurant.
Oh. Did we... rant about that already?
I don't know if we ranted about it. If we didn't,
should we take a brief tangent?
All right, let's take a brief tangent on this. Always gotta do this difficultly. All right, so we went to eat on, I just spit, I hope I didn't see, I'm sorry if you guys had to see that. So we went to eat out on Friday. Well, I'm not saying where we ate, and I'm not gonna say
anything more about that.
However, I will say that the service wasn't great. It could have been that they were just really busy, and it's not usually like that. But considering
it was Valentine's Day,
but considering the reviews, it's not looking too great. They just forgot about us several times.
It would have been one thing if I would have seen her bustling around.
Yeah.
And, like, taking... I'm sorry. I apologize. There it is. It would have been one thing if I was, like, seeing her bustling around and, like, helping other people and seeing her on the floor.
But
we didn't.
She was just gone. Like, and then I was like, okay. Like, she forgot Meredith's drink. Forgot about Luke's refill of a drink for a long time.
Had to ask two other waitresses for something.
Listen, we were in Good Omens cosplay. We were trying to get the good dessert shots. We just needed the dessert.
So we got dessert. It was burnt. They didn't tell Luke and Meredith that the dessert they ordered, like, wasn't available until after they brought Morgan and mine. They're like, oh, by the way. And then it was like, the dessert was burnt, and then we needed to pay. So I get that it might be difficult, but she like kept giving us like the wrong receipt like several times and kept having to like run back to the
to go reprint it
because she kept like getting the wrong one, and it was like, okay, which was fine, I get it, like, it's busy, you can make mistakes like that. But then, so Morgan and I paid in cash, and she gives Morgan her receipt with the change, and by change I mean the dollar change, but none of the other change, and she pockets my receipt as well as all my change and walks away. So I never got my receipt back. So I got up, went and asked me, like, hey, can I have my receipt and my change? And she was like, oh, yeah, let me go get that. So she reprinted it, and she's like, I have to go get change. And it was like,
just give me the change in your pocket.
Just give me the change in your pocket. I saw you pocket it. I'm not, like, if it was, like a policy, like, hey, like if, like, upfront, like, hey, can I, like, use this as my tip? Sure. I really wouldn't have minded if, like, her service was better, but because it was so not great, it just made me super annoyed at the time. Anyway, so enough about that. So, least favorite part of the con, aside from
page.
That whole is bad. How packed and busy it would get inside, like, especially, there was times that, I mean, it's a big convention, and I get that it's gonna, like, just be kind of crowded, but, it's just so crowded and loud at times that it was, like, hard to move and hard to hear people, I think that's my least favorite part.
If you are someone prone to anxiety.
Yeah, if you are prone to anxiety and, like, or you are, if
or
you're
claustrophobia
or anything, like, with people, like, touching you,
you're definitely gonna need a buddy.
You'll need, like, a buddy system.
So, like, you can, like, if you need to get out, they can get you out.
Yeah, so if you start getting overwhelmed, you can be like, hey, I, like, need to get out of the building, or, like, I need to be out in the open. They can kind of guide you through the convention. Because it gets super packed. I don't really know their policy about the gazebo shoot, because I still did not understand it. People were shooting in it, but I just...
do not understand how to get up there.
I don't understand how to, like, take pictures there, and I, like, don't understand, like, the etiquette of it. So I was like, good for everyone who got one, but I have no idea how that works. So... but yeah, that's my least favorite part of the con, was just the amount of, like... crowdedness and like the volume. Oh, and the fact that our hotel didn't have a pool, I was really sad, because we were all like, all right guys, we're gonna be in the hot tub.
I use precious suitcase space for my bathing suit.
It's such a fancy hotel, it should have a pool.
No, we weren't like in the hotel.
Not the Katsu was, like, hotel, the Katsu, but we're hotel, like, across the street,
obviously. Because it did look like they had a pool. I'm not sure how, like, warm it would have been in there, but
yeah,
perhaps.
But, like, the one was outside that we saw.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, well, it was, like, outside, but, like, in, like, a...
like, an outside indoor.
Sort of thing.
Yeah. Meredith.
What?
Here, wait, let me do this so I can actually see what I'm doing.
I was like...
Sorry, Morgan. You're gonna have to deal with that. Meredith. Least favorite part of the con?
Probably just the crowds. I really like big cons because I like having more of a variety of people.
Oh yeah.
And also I feel like it's easier to justify my hobbies to people that don't understand them, where I can be like, a lot of people come to this, it's not just me. You know, I don't mind even like walking through crowds that much, because I always have Luke to use as a battering ram.
Mm-hmm.
It's really just like... photo space is hard, and when people, I hate when people get in your photos, or they like linger behind you when they see you're obviously trying to take a picture.
Oh god, bad.
I'm trying to be a narcissist. Go away. Go away. That's it. Everything else is fine.
Luke, your least favorite part of the con?
Actually, Rayleigh's favorite part of the con is any time that we go to a con and Luke either can't see or can't hear, and I gotta repeat myself 500 times, and then he gets mad about it.
All right, well, that was gonna be my least favorite, but it's not gonna be that anymore because, okay, apparently we've covered it. It was really hard for me to be completely blind.
But I don't, like, I'm mind really sorry. Leading you around and discussing. No, it's just when you're
actually
wearing, like, a
actually,
wig. Whenever he wears a wig, I say anything, and he's just like, what?
I'm actually, actually hurting.
And then
hearing,
no,
like,
and then
real.
I speak up, and then you're like, oh, well, I'm sorry. Like,
no, you sound like you're mad at me.
No, I'm not.
I get that, because, like, I have sometimes...
Morgan does it to me.
I'm like, oh, well, here, and I was just like, but I just, I sound like I'm yelling, and Seth's like, don't yell at me, and like, oh, no, I'm just trying to talk loud.
I have baby ears, okay? They need delicacy. And gentle touch. And stop.
Yes. Yeah,
I hate myself. Please delete this.
Some fries. Well, yeah, I was... I'm really sad about it because I really like my contacts that I got for Crowley.
Mm-hmm.
They look really cool. But one, I'm not used to putting contacts in, so it's like hard for me already. And it takes a long time to get used to. And then two, like once they were in, like the holes to see through are like half the size of normal ones to make it like more like snake eyes,
mm-hmm.
like slits. And I was just, like, actually completely blind. Like, I couldn't see. Aww. Like anything, basically. Like I can see like vague shapes like far off or really up close, but like everything in like the normal distance.
So more like they would be like photo shoot contacts and then immediately take them out.
Yeah. Thank you for literally reaching into my eyeballs and taking them out too.
That's real friendship.
Yeah. That, and then I guess just some of the stuff like didn't have as many signs or whatever up during the con.
Yeah.
For to see like where stuff is. There was a lot of times where I was really confused and I was lost. Like where I am. And, like, I would ask somebody, and, like, the people who are volunteering for the con, like, obviously they're stressed out because they're volunteering at this, like, an anime convention. Like, I can't even imagine. Like, I could never. But also, like, they would be really stressed out, so they would be a little bit snappy. But it's just because they're stressed out. Like, it's not, I don't hold it against them or whatever. Mm-hmm. But, like, and people probably go up to them and ask them, like, really, really dumb questions all day.
Right.
But, yeah, I don't know. It makes me feel...
I just feel bad. I'm like,
stupid.
You know how, you know that TikTok where it goes, A for dick for deck?
A for tip for deck?
And you go, what? That's scabbard, literally, every time they were talking about, where is this? I was like, oh, where is this place? And they'd just be like, A for dick for deck? Like, huh? Because I was like, oh, I just go, okay. And I had no idea.
All right, let's see.
All of our, like, most favorite parts of the con that we said earlier, all of us did a cosplay. So, like, other than cosplay, what was, like, a thing up, like, about the con specifically that you liked?
Morgan? I'm thinking, only think? I just got here!
I've only been doing this for 2 fucking days.
It can be a thing you did in cosplay, but...
Yeah.
Because I've got one.
Okay, you go first then, please, please, please.
You're going out of order!
Oh my god!
Okay,
we've gone off the rails. I really enjoy doing the purikura. I've never done it before. Yeah, the photos. I've never done it before, and yeah, some of them look like wild, because like the eyes are ginormous.
There's no way to jack down the.
But
that it was doki fun doki look.
Like, I got more photos of like just all of us together as a group and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
They're just really nice, and I like hang them up like by my bed so I can like look at them before I go to sleep at night and be like, hey, here's my friends.
Here's my friends.
My friends.
My
friends. You gotta get a photo with a picture like every time we're hanging out now.
Oh yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
We have to.
It's the tradition.
We need to.
We have to do looks each time because like I gotta be vibing in my whole aesthetic.
Mm-hmm. Alright, let me turn it
on. Can I hold it while you do it, Sam?
No, I don't mind.
Alright, so my favorite part of the con, like, besides, like, being in cosplay, is also something that happened while we were in cosplay, which was, 2 things. One was the Met Gala, which was a really cool experience. Like, Morgan and I weren't picked to, like, individually walk, which was fine.
We just came in a group.
But it was just cool to see everyone's, like, we had been following these people's designs since we joined, the Facebook group. And then to see them in person was like, oh my god! And, like, some people, like, hadn't posted any pictures of their looks. And then to see them all at once was kind of really cool. And then, both our photo shoot with our photographer, which is Sarah Lynn, and we'll post her links and info in the description, and the photo shoot we did with you, with Luke and Meredith, and they took our pictures, and that was really, really cool and fun to do. Mm-hmm. And I just thought that was a fun thing to do together.
Mm-hmm.
I really enjoyed, like, taking the time to, like, take everyone's photos and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, I don't know why at past cons, like, sometimes we've been sleeping on that. We've just been like,
we're excited to go do stuff.
We do get really excited.
Or we're real excited to go back into the artist alley. Because a lot of the times, I don't know, there wasn't as many, like, people taking commissions at this con.
Yeah.
But a lot of times, like, animesmen or whatever, we're like, oh, I gotta get back down there, gotta get my commission, and then we, like, don't.
Right, because, like, I feel like Katsu2020 is, like, a con that you go take, like, pictures in.
Yeah.
And it's very much a cosplay-oriented con rather than, like, Animazement, which is a...
I think the Artist Alley at Animazement is bigger, isn't it?
Yeah. Artist Alley at Animazement is huge. It's pretty much the same size as the dealer's room.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Meredith.
Yes.
Favorite part of the con besides not your cosplay. That's not your cosplay. It can be something that happened in cosplay. But
I don't know, the BL panel was fun. That's always fun.
Yeah.
Was it fun?
It was learning a lot of things. It's very educational.
They had like legit sources and everything. It was really cool.
Oh wow.
It's like, pass me these links.
Man. Yeah, really.
Yeah.
Your favorite part of Luke, your favorite part of the con besides being a cosplay?
I really liked that since it was, I know I mentioned it earlier. But I really liked that since it was Valentine's Day, people were like handing out gifts to each other all
the
time.
That was the coolest thing. It was so cute. I wish I had gotten Valentine's and like given them to people.
I want to do that when we come again because I really, really liked that. And then I like had been thinking about the thing I wanted to say this whole time and I just like totally forgot what it was. Something along those lines, though.
Was it a gift you received?
No. Oh, I'm so angry.
Oh, well, you got a ribbon.
Yeah, that wasn't it, but I really liked that. We got the little ribbons for our Good Omens shoot.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
I'm so mad. I forgot.
Think about it. You can think about it for a little bit.
Let me think about it, and I'll, like, definitely interrupt somebody.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, I got two questions.
Okay.
One. Favorite thing you bought, or favorite thing you got, whatever.
Yeah.
However the monetary exchange went.
Yeah.
And then, tips on people who want to go to Katsu and don't know anything about, like, what it means, like, what how much it costs and stuff.
Okay, Morgan, you want to start us off on that?
Yeah, okay, favorite thing I got, bought was, you got me the, like, it's a button-up, and it has, like, a bunch of, like, game controllers on it and stuff, and like grid. I don't know. I've been trying to get more button ups.
Mm-hmm.
Me too.
They've been in my fashion inspiration for Pinterest or whatever, because I like that like weird, like half unbuttoned, androgynous look.
Mm-hmm. And then a tip for someone that wants to go to Katsu but hasn't gone yet.
Definitely budget. Always have a budget set for how much you want to spend, like in the alleys and dealer's room or whatever, and then you have to realistically think about how much a room is going to cost, how much travel is going to cost, if you have to rent a car or not, because all of those like add up
quickly.
Yeah. And like that also helps you decide like, oh, do I want to share a room with somebody, and then like how many people you want to share a room with, and mm-hmm. be realistic
when you want to share a room with someone, like, and make sure that you're okay with, like, sharing your space with them.
Exactly. Yeah.
Alright.
What are y'all trying to say? I'm
joking.
Oh, no, we're saying it works for us because, like...
We're all comfortable. we're literally all so comfortable with y'all. I'm like, just like, what up?
Well, because, like, I imagine, like, spending, like, your time in a room for, like, 3 days, and if it's, like, someone, like, oh, I met them on the internet... And I've never met them before.
Yeah.
Like, that would be super awkward, at least to me. I don't know if it makes that make sense for everyone, but for me, that would be a lot. Do it. All right, let me see. Okay. So, my favorite purchase. That's hard. Oh, can I name two?
Sure.
So, we found the Kingdom Hearts 1. These figures for them, and they were $20 each, and I got Sora and Riku, and they're really, really cute, and it's cool because that's my favorite, it's my favorite game, and they're my favorite characters. And then Morgan got me an aesthetic Inuyasha and Kagome shirt, which is really cool, and they have like Tokyo street fashion, and I like how it looks, and it's very fashionable. So I like that. Tips for if you're wanting to go to Katsu, it's not what Morgan said.
About food.
Ooh. Food. Okay. So think about, this is expenses too. So if you're a kind of person that's like, oh my gosh, I want to eat out, realize eating out is going to get expensive super fast. Even if you...
there's not really... Fast food.
Fast food is not around Katsu unless you're willing to drive. Like, it's a long walk, and it's also, it gets really cold at night.
Oh my god,
here.
It got so cold.
It got so cold. So think about how much your food's gonna cost. I recommend bringing your own food
The hotel we stayed at did not have a microwave, but it did have a coffee maker, and we could boil water and, like, pour it into
I mean, it was a fail. It was definitely a fail.
It didn't really work super well for what we brought, but, it, like, if you have that, it'll probably work for you.
Coffee maker mac and cheese. Coffee maker mac and cheese.
And another thing, plan your cosplays according to the weather. If it's, if it seems like it's gonna be cold and windy, don't bring something that's, like, just a yukata.
Do as I say, not as I do.
Yeah, do as I say, not as I do. All right, Meredith.
Favorite purchase.
Favorite purchase.
Favorite purchase. My purse. I just really like my purse. I'm obsessed with my purse. Y'all already saw my purse. You're seeing my purse again. My purse.
Wait, let me zoom in. It's really pretty.
It's
I just really,
really, really cute. Mm-hmm. It's extra. I can't wait to set it down on tables and people be like, what is that?
What is that?
And you're like, my purse.
Tall, high fashion.
You wouldn't understand.
That, and I like that I now am the proud owner of not one, but two Aziraphale buttons.
Wait, I'm wearing them.
Oh, my nipples.
Fantastic.
Aziraphale fan club.
Any tips for anyone who wants to go to Katsu?
Get to your pre-hydrine early on Thursday.
Oh my god, yeah.
We were still getting ready for an hour after it opened.
I felt bad. That was my fault because I'm a narcissist.
But you looked good though, so it's fine. So but like, and we like we made it. But
pre-reg is there because there's so many people. If you did pre-reg, try to get there as early as you can.
Yeah.
You can always go back to your room and get ready. But there's also not really any. At least this year, there was nothing happening on Thursday at KatsuCon.
Yeah.
So unless you have a photo shoot or you have like you're gonna go party and drink and stuff. Then I would say like skip the cosplay for now until you get your pre-reg.
Yeah.
Unless you start getting ready really early.
That's what I did.
Luke, favorite purchase and then any tips for Katsu?
Y'all are really gonna make me choose between all of my purchases, huh?
Yeah. Like kept on.
Sure are.
Really, like kept it up.
I really.
I really picked two.
I really like all of the Good Omens stuff that I bought because, I don't know, maybe, I mean, it probably definitely is because there wasn't a con that we've gone to since Animazement, which was, like, before Good Omens really came out.
Like, the week before it came out, like, it sucked.
But I was really pleasantly surprised with, like, how much Good Omens stuff there was at this anime convention.
Mm-hmm.
So all of my Good Omens stuff I'm, like, very, like, happy about.
Yay.
Don't take photos in walkways.
Yeah.
Oh,
I mean, we definitely did that, so, like, don't.
Also, at KatsuCon staff, this one lady was like, you can't wear your pass around your wrist because that's the way it gets lost or whatever. And I was like, okay, thanks. She was like, you gotta wear it around your neck. And I was like, okay, well, thanks for the tip. Not gonna do that. Like.
Well, because, like.
Yeah, but then you saw another lady.
Lipstick in my
palette. Yeah, and then like later I literally went up to another lady and I was asking her for directions how to get to the room that the BL panel was in, and she was literally like, oh my gosh, wearing it around your wrist is so smart. We should like make all of them like that, like little bracelets to put on your wrists. And I was like, yeah, you should. Because she's like, because it's easier.
It is.
To take pictures of your cosplay when you have to pull this long badge up of your wig head.
Oh my god,
your wigged head.
Luke, any advice for people wanting to go to Katsu?
You would not believe that I just had it.
Oh
my gosh. Yeah, I mean, we kind of touched on it, but like the wind is wild.
Yeah.
Wear a warm cosplay.
Yeah, bring like I don't want to say wear a coat because I live in Michigan and I know that like coats like ruin an outfit. But like
I would say
bring something that's easy, like you can like drape, at least drape over you, so, yeah. And then you can take off, like put it in your bag or something while you're in cosplay. Oh. If you don't
break cloaks in your yeah. cosplay.
If you're not at the Gaylord and you're not like actually in the convention center and you have to actually walk outside, you need a way to stay warm.
For ones yeah. wanting to wear like the bunny suits or anything like that have more skin exposed, utilize dance tights. They're completely opaque. But they're warm as can be. You can get even fleece-lined ones, but I recommend...
Those are skater tights.
Those are skater tights, my bad.
Fleece-lined leggings but are the shit.
Honestly, like, that just utilizes, like, warmth, and also it makes you feel more covered, so you're more secure, so that way, no matter what, like, if you're, like, bending over or, like, squatting down to get something, it's not like, oh my god, I'm gonna have exposures. The way up there. But,
just exposures.
But yeah, I guess that's our...
Oh, sorry, I'm just gonna say this. None of you will probably ever see this, but if you are at the Good Omens Meetup, I love you.
I love you.
I love you. You're awesome. The fact that you guys just like Good Omens, I love you. Because I just... You're all very cool, and every time I think about Aziraphale and Crowley, I legitimately want to burst into tears. And there's a fic that I'm gonna read later where I'm definitely gonna burst into tears, because the fic summary was basically like, they can't touch each other in any way because angels and demons like can't, so like they're not gonna be able to like hold hands and stuff. And I was like, I'm gonna burst into tears. Yes. But like, it's about the pining.
It's about the pining. Hey Sam, your butt's ringing.
I know.
You've got a phone ringing. It's dead.
Hello.
Hi.
Talk about Good Omens.
How are you?
Watching to stand Good Omens.
We're on the road.
Good Omens Nation. Rise up.
We're on 95.
Aziraphale is my bias. Hello.
I think I didn't answer like two entire questions because I forgot what I was gonna say.
Good morning, Good Omens Nation.
Are you okay?
Rise up.
All right. So.
Hello, Good Omens Nation.
Hello. All right. Well, Morgan, I guess it's time to sign off. Will you say bye?
Can we do one more thing?
Yeah.
Can we do a meme review?
Oh, yeah.
That's our meme review.
Yeah.
All right.
All right.
Meme review watch.
Meme review time. one of them is the official squad name. Fucking Ganucci.
Ganucci.
Ganucci gang.
Ganucci gang.
And then the other one is... It's been a lot of what if
basically, what if we did anything or went anywhere, and then we kissed. What if we went to the anime convention, Katsu2020, and we kissed?
What if we accidental kissed? What would you do?
What would you even do?
What would you do?
I would also just like to say, sorry, I liked, another reason that I liked the Good Omens photo shoot is that everyone there, except for the one single, like, anathema, and the one single bees.
There was two Beelzebubs.
There was two bees. And other than them, there was, like, no one else except Aziraphale and Crowley, so they were like, hey, anybody here that's, like, this do we have anyone?
Do we have a Michael?
Do we have any of them? Like, everyone was like,
do we have a
Tracy. Catch my Madame Tracy cosplay coming in 2020.
Nice.
20.
You will not catch me as Sergeant Shadwell, though.
Why would I make you do that?
Unless you all have other memes, I think that's it.
No, I think that's it.
That's it.
All right, Morgan, will you begin our sign-off?
All right. Thanks for tuning in, I guess. And we'll see you at Animazement.
Yeah.
You know, goodbye. I won't even have all my money earned back yet, but we'll be good.
Yeah, no.
Oh, wait,
yeah.
Morgan, do you want to make promises now so that you can break them again?
Okay. Animazement, be like... Katsu than animes would be like, I'll complain when it's cold, I'll complain when it's hot. You'll find there isn't anything that I can't complain about.
I'm gonna try. Just two. I'm going to make two cosplays for Animazement, and that's it. Everything else being reused, and I'm going to try to stick with it this time, I promise. Don't look at me like that.
Doubt.png.
We all look at Morgan like...
Doubt. L.
All right. Morgan, want to say bye?
I did just say bye.
We'll say bye, actually.
Just to make Morgan angry, but if you know the name of the new guy,
No. Not please.
He's Socialist King.
I'm cutting that down. I'm not going in the vlog. No.
The Discord continues.
When you can chase a bag.
No.
Cutthroat in here.
No.
Chase the bag.
Bye.
I'm up here vibing.
What if we were in the car and we danced like this?
I can't see you.
Just this little bee.